Once again, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the second part of our concert here this evening. The brass band of Battle Creek has asked me to make an announcement before I introduce our music, and that is to say we'd like to send our congratulations to all the winners from today's contests, and also to really say thank you to all the participants, because taking part is obviously the most important thing in the end. So from us, congratulations to the winners and the usual commiserations to the losers. We're going to begin with three pieces taken from a suite that I arranged quite a few years ago of tunes by Irving Berlin. The first one is rather unusual, and I'm not going to tell you the title of it because that will become plain in the course of the piece. But basically, it's an argument. Now, all groups of peoples, whether it's family or ensembles, they all have arguments, and the band's going to have an argument. The second piece is one of those lovely, gentle melodies that Irving Berlin was so good at. It's a lovely day tomorrow. And then finally, putting on the Ritz. Now, I've taken some liberties with this particular piece because when I was arranging it, I was drawn to remembering an old recording of Putting on the Ritz that I heard on my grandmother's wind-up gramophone. Now, we're going back quite a few years, and for those of you like me of a certain age plus, obviously it takes us right back. And my grandmother's wind-up gramophone suffered from a great shortage of gramophone needles, as well as having a rather poor mechanism. But of course, during the early war years, gramophone needles didn't come very high on Winston Churchill's list of priorities. So we had to do the best we could, and even to the extent of trying to sharpen the occasional needle with some glass paper. So Putting on the Ritz will bring the suite to a conclusion. So please pay attention and listen to our argument. Thank you. So after those little pieces of nonsense, we turn to something rather more serious. Bluebells of Scotland by Arthur Pryor is one of those peaks of the trombone virtuoso repertoire, which I'm sure every trombonist at least owns the music, if not plays it through. And we have specially tonight from Montreal, a star who's played with the band before, and we're very delighted that he's going to play with us again tonight, Alain Trudel. Please give him the very best welcome. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. As you may have heard, there are some quite good trombone players around tonight. In fact, they're not bad at all. In fact, you'd go a long way to find a trombone team quite as fine as this one that we have tonight. In my section with the euphoniums and baritones, sometimes we have a hard job sitting where we do, right in the middle of the stun zone of the trombone section. And with some sections, trying to get in tune with the trombones is like trying to run a marathon on quicksand. But we used to be able to taunt them that they couldn't play fast enough without the valves, but Mr. Trudel has once and forever dispelled that myth. And they also play great jazz. They also get gigs in symphony orchestra. And they have the added bonus of at any time when they choose, they can drown out the rest of the band. So we are delighted and proud to present all four of them, Wyclef Gordon and Scott Hartman and Alain Trudel and Mark Frost, in a beautiful arrangement by a young man who is here tonight, who has a good association with the band, Dave Henderson, a beautiful arrangement of I'm Getting Sentimental Over You. Let's give our superstar team a welcome. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Edward Carroll, if you'd report to the CD desk after the concert, you left something there, and I bet you know right now what it is. Edward Carroll. Jim and Bill Gray, the gentlemen that organized this band back in 1990, originally came from the Cincinnati area. They have many fine memories of Cincinnati, including the Big Red Machine, the opera at the zoo, and people like Ruth Lyons, Paul Dixon, and Marion Spellman. They grew up on the outskirts of Cincinnati in Terrace Park, which is close to the farm of one of the most important native sons of this fair city, Henry Fillmore. In addition, Terrace Park was also the wintering grounds for the Robinson Circus, so perhaps that helps explain how this next selection was chosen. And to give an even greater Cincinnati flavor to this piece, we've invited some area musicians to join us. They are, do we have them here? Ah, good. We have John Monroe of the College Conservatory of Music playing cornet. Kevin Lynch of Coleraine High School on trumpet, and Robin Hale. Triangle Youth Brass Band of Raleigh, North Carolina on euphonium. We welcome them. This is a tradition with the Brass Band of Battle Creek. We often have high school and college age young people assist the band on particular numbers, and we're happy to do that here in Cincinnati. Now, I've already told you this band was started back in 1990, but I didn't tell you how. The Brass Band of Battle Creek grew out of one of those Yamaha Corporation Brass Band seminars. The gentleman conducting that seminar is the same man that will be conducting our next selection, because without Dr. Paul Drosty, we simply would not be here to share in this great evening. Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Drosty. The Brass Band of Battle Creek, with friends, performing Henry Fillmore's Circus Bee.
Thank you very much. We won't sound the same without you. Next, we're going to bring you a moment from a movie that made all of us very much richer. Brassed Off brought brass band awareness from England to the United States in a very big way. And as a matter of fact, many of our students are still renting this at Blockbuster and places like that, and they find for the first time the beautiful music of brass band. We're going to bring you one of the great moments of that movie. This is the adagio from the Concierto by Aranjuez, composed by Rodrigo. And in the movie, it features the most stunningly beautiful, almost dangerously beautiful woman playing the flugelhorn in this next piece. Now tonight, we've decided to use a Hollywood stunt double to play the flugelhorn. Mr. Tim Morrison, who has a spectacular career, and he has been co-principal trumpet of the Boston Symphony, principal trumpet of the Boston Pops. Scott Hartman and I spent many years with him in the Empire Brass, and now he's John Williams' favorite trumpet player out in Hollywood. You've heard him in many movies, like Apollo 13 and Born on the 4th of July, and now we're going to use him as a Hollywood stunt double. Mr. Tim Morrison.
At this point in the evening, Sam and I are just going to spend 2 minutes talking about Camp Avalon, and Sam will translate into American.
Dude, Camp Avalon, dude.
So we are very proud here in the Brass Band of Battle Creek that after years of planning, finally this summer launches the first Brass Band Summer School from the Brass Band of Battle Creek, Camp Avalon.
Way cool.
We are particularly proud that we have we have the principal players from the band involved in the camp, and that the actual venue for this place, very close to Battle Creek, Michigan, our home, is one of the most, in fact, the most wonderful venue that we've ever seen for a summer camp, isn't it, Sam? I dread to think what's coming next.
It's good.
So, you've been filling in forms tonight. We are now going to be very pleased to announce who has won a free place at Camp Avalon. And after the concert's finished, we'd be delighted to talk to anyone, either here or back at the reception, anyone who's interested in joining us this summer, July 20 to 27, at Sherman Lake Camp.
Y'all come.
Okay. Dwight Wages, you're going to assist us in this process. Okay. Okay. There you go.
I've always wanted to be in this position. You know, it's like the Miss America contest. In fact, we're going to pull two more, but we're not going to announce them, because if this person can't go for some reason, then we'll have the other names. The winner from Ohio, Suspense, on B-flat tuba, Matthew Hayes, Johnstown Monroe High School.
Congratulations, Matthew. We'll look forward to seeing you at Camp Avalon.
And number three.
You announced these?
No. Okay. Mark a three on that. Okay, very good. Excellent. Thank you.
Good.
Well, this has been a wonderful night. You know, I didn't do that to elicit applause from you folks. You have been a marvelous, wonderfully responsive audience, and the band appreciates it. We really do. Our band wants to thank the North American Brass Band Association, the Cincinnati Brass Band, and the gentleman that coordinated our appearance here, Mr. Dwight Wages. Thanks again, Dwight. Our last selection is an old big band favorite, Sing, Sing, Sing. Even though the Brass Band of Battle Creek is a brass band in the British tradition, we are very much recognized by this American classic. Our first CD is entitled Sing, Sing, Sing. Conducting this jazz classic, we once again have Sam Palafian at the front of our stage, professor of jazz studies at Arizona State University. Please enjoy now as our band features Danny Barber, Chris Jodis, Wycliffe Gordon, and Mark Wolfley with Louis Prima's Sing, Sing, Sing. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
one or two words of thanks at the end of tonight's concert. First of all, most importantly, the organizers of today's events. Now, I know from personal experience how much time and trouble large events can take, and it can't really be overstated. The thanks that's due to Dwight Wages and the Cincinnati Brass Band. Please give them a terrific welcome. Is Mr. Wages here? I'd also like to add that the founders of the Brass Band of Battle Creek, Jim and Bill Gray, have done tremendous work with the band over the years, and I think in producing this kind of ensemble for your enjoyment, I think they also deserve a very big vote of thanks. And just one or two words of reminder of tonight's soloists, but first of all, to mention our narrator, Terry Bobzien. Then, in order of playing for our soloists, we had Stephen Mead. Wycliffe Gordon. Alain Trudel. And, of course, Tim Morrison. I'd just like to try to maybe right a small wrong as far as Tim's concerned, because Sam's introductory remarks could have been taken to be sort of slightly slighting. Sam kept mentioning this dangerously attractive flugelhorn player in the film, as if suggesting that Tim is not dangerously attractive. Perhaps in a certain light, but I thought I detected a certain, should we say, hairist bias. Against what my wife calls a low-maintenance hairstyle. I have to tell you, just a word about this without too much digression, you don't get hairstyles like this free. You have to earn them. They don't sort of come with Green Shield stamps or anything like that. The hair is actually burnt off from the inside by intense intellectual activity. So I suggest the next time you need a flugelhorn player, don't think about attractive young girls. Think about Tim and the fact that he's probably capable of rocket science, and I'm sure he's fully house-trained as well. So I'm So Sam, give up your dangerous attraction before it becomes fatal. However, joking apart, thank you very much for your very kind reception here this evening. The band has enjoyed playing to you enormously, and I hope that you've enjoyed our offerings for you. We'd like to play an encore for you, and we've chosen something which we think you'll find is a very nice contrast to the previous item, with its tremendous excitement. This one obviously is quite different, and it features a melody made famous by Judy Garland, I'm sorry. In this case, it's going to be played by our horn soloist, because unfortunately Judy Garland is not available. She's on tour with Beethoven at the moment. But our own soloist has got a certain, shall I say, elfin charm, perhaps not dangerously attractive, but sometimes attractively dangerous, maybe, but William Rushworth is going to play for us Over the Rainbow.
Thank you.